Hi everyone, I hope you had a good weekend. Today we're going to look at Luke chapter 1, starting in verse 46, and read Mary's prayer. My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked on the humble estate of his servant. For behold, from now on all generations will call me blessed. For he who is mighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. And his mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the mighty from their thrones and exalted those of humble estate. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, as he spoke to our fathers, to Abraham and to his offspring forever. Did you know that Mary's prayer includes at least a dozen Old Testament scripture references? This is particularly interesting when you consider that women were not educated in this time. Mary was likely illiterate. And so the only opportunity that she would have had to learn these things would be going to the temple and listening to the teachers. Obviously, she did that frequently because this prayer is full of scripture. It's references of what God had done in the past. And so her mind was saturated with, and she memorized the words of God. I think that it's far too easy for us to skip over the scriptures, especially when it comes to memorizing scripture. It takes a lot of time and energy and effort, and we don't always make it a priority like we should. Mary made it a priority, and it was much harder for her to make it a priority because she was a woman. She didn't have access like we do, and we have access like you wouldn't believe. You can get the Bible anywhere at any time. You can get it on your phone. You can listen to it. You can get dramatized versions of it. You can have, I don't know about you, but I have probably 8 or 10 Bibles just sitting around my house. And yet, it can be hard to actually remember to make it a priority, to sit down every day and spend time reading scripture. But it's so valuable. It's so important. It's important for us personally because it helps us to keep our mind fixed on the things of God. It helps us to see the world through his perspective. And it helps us to be able to recognize where God is at work. We can see and encounter people and be able to see them as God sees them because we have set aside a time in the morning or in the afternoon or whenever it is that you're best able to focus to spend time with God. That now can be the lens through which you see the rest of your day. And so as you're going about your day, instead of seeing problems, you can see opportunities. Instead of seeing difficult people, you can see people who God has called you to love and have patience and show them mercy when they get on your nerves. It gives us a perspective of the things of God. More so than that, even though, it allows us to be able to minister to those that God puts in our path along the way. We don't need to be able to know everything, but we do need to know what God says. And how are we going to be able to be women who are influential and who are godly and are used by God if we don't know scripture, if we don't know how to point people to scripture? When somebody comes to you and expresses a problem or a struggle that they're dealing with, do you know how to take them to scripture and show them what God says? Or do you just sympathize with them and hope that things get better, but don't necessarily have any specific information or direction from God? It's so important because pastors are not the only ones who are called to encourage and equip people. All of us are. And if we spend time focusing on the Word of God, it allows us to share that Word and those scriptures with other people when they need it, to get God's perspective when they need it, just like we need it from time to time. All of us need that person in our lives who will show us the truth in scripture when we don't know where to find it ourselves, but we also need to be that for other people. And so I encourage you to consider the priority that you place on the Word of God. Mary was a woman of the Word, and she did it at great effort. It doesn't take a whole lot of effort for us. It takes 15 or 20 minutes a day to sit down and put away the distractions and focus on God's word. There are multiple ways that you can do that beyond just sitting down for 10 minutes a day or 20 minutes a day or however much time that you have. You can also spend time in your car. Putting on the Bible app has different types of versions that are able to be read aloud to you as you're driving. There are dramatized audiobooks of the Bible, particularly for the New Testament, are very interesting. We did that with the youth group a couple years ago from Faith Comes by Hearing, and they have an app as well. You can be able to saturate your mind with the Word of God, even as you're going about your day running errands, and that's a beautiful thing. I know that's not easy because when you get in the car, you'd rather, you know, make phone calls or listen to music or that kind of thing. But what if you just set aside 1 or 2 times a day where you just focus on God's word? it will change your life.